In this video, I will disassemble, I will tear down this BMW ACC radar. I want to see if I'm able to open it without destroying it. I want to see if I'm able to find what is the problem and to see how this unit is built and what have inside of it. This particular radar, it's ACC2, it's the second generation mounted on BMW cars. This one was removed from a BMW 7 Series, F01 or F02, something like that. And this one is made in 2009. I have this radar here for a very long period of time and I have kept it specially for this video. Unfortunately, because I have it for a long period of time, I have forgot what problem this radar have. From what I remember, I think the radar will respond on the diagnosed equipment, but will have an internal error. So before I will start to dismantle it, I want to see if I'm able to reconnect with this one here on my bench to see what error it have and to see if I will find the problem and maybe to repair it. So enough with talking and let's start to work. I have here a wiring diagram for this radar. The connections are very simple. This thing from here is the long range sensor, this guy. This will have two pins, two wires for 12 volts power supply from a fuse. They are connected together here. One wire, one pin for ground or minus, and two wires, two pins for CAN communication, CAN high and CAN low. On F series, this radar is connected on S-CAN network directly to the ICM, Integrated Chassis Management. On F-Series, this network is only between these two units. And being so, at this time, I'm not able to test this radar now because on my testing bench, I don't have this module, the ICM. But I won't say that because I will be able to test it using the E-Series testing bench. Because on E-Series, this radar is mounted on PTK network and the PTK network is supported, it's created by the ZGM, the safety and gateway module. So being so, I will be able to use that bench for test this radar. With this said, let me set up my testing bench and to see if I'm able to scan it and see what errors we'll have. Okay, now let me take out the testing bench from here. You can see this is my place where I keep the testing benches. This one is for F-series, the CIC, CIS, monitor, the cluster, everything except the ICM. I don't have it in this configuration. Next, let me put this aside. Here I have the E60 testing bench. CIS with the ZGM. I will take this one. Also, I have here testing bench for E65, the wiring with everything. I have different ignition switch for this testing bench. I have testing bench for night vision, parking module and other things. So with this testing bench, this one have the old type of ignition switch with the old key, but that is not important. The important thing is the connection and the ZGM. The CIS will need to be here for switch on the ignition and send wake up to the ZGM, and the ZGM will do everything else. Next, I will need some pins. I will use these two pins for CAN. This one it's good for ground. And these two ones are good for power supply. Something like that. Now I need to connect the pins. First, let's see the pin order. Pin 1, 4, 5 and 8. I will start with pin 1, it's brown, it's ground. like so. Next, pin 4 and 8 are plus 12 volts. These two wires are perfect. Pin 4 and 8. And last two pins are pin 2 and 3. I will use the twisted wires. Pin 3 and a last one, pin 2, something like that. Next, here on my testing bench, I need to put this in a order. These are the main power supply for this bench, brown minus, red plus. So I will do something like that. Brown with brown minus. These ones I said they are plus 12 volts. Perfect. Next, on this wiring on this bench, the PT can is red and blue with red. I will connect them here. It doesn't matter if I will put the PT can in reverse or not. Can high with can low for this test. Perfect. Next step, I will power up my power supply. 13 volts, perfect. Plus, it's here, minus here. This is the ignition. I have here some marks. That LED is ignition on, now it's ignition off. And in this part, it's ignition on. Next step, I will take the ICOM from here. I will set it on my bench. And I will make a connection here. It's online. Next step. On ISTA, I will select the head, set up connection, and at this moment, this scanning will take a very long time because I have a ton of modules that are missing from this wiring. So I will be in a second back with this card scanned. After 45 minutes or something like that, this is the car. The CIS is responding because it's in this network, the ZGM, and the long range radar. Let me see what errors we have. Long range radar, internal sensor fault, long range radar, adaptive brake because the ABS is missing, SCAN communication fault is not present, and rest of the errors are about no communication. So I have internal sensor fault. No bueno. Because I don't know what error is that. It's only telling me that I have an internal error. Component triggering, delete fault memories. ACU, let me see. ACU perform. Only physical hardware number I'm able to read from here. Okay. Long range radar, no can message, adaptive brake assistant. Now I need to rescan it. Okay, the internal fault memory is not present now. No can message, because all the messages that this radar will expect, this car is not able to provide them. Now, if I have seen these things, I will turn down this radar. First, I will start with heat. I will apply a ton of heat on the radar. You can see on the radar, I have these clips that will keep in place the rear cover and these ones for the front cover. But these covers are glued here between this cover and the case. It's a special glue that is very, very strong. Oopsie. I think I need to cut this clip from here to have more access here. Yeah, I mean. Oops, this is for science. Yeah, this was much simpler. You can see behind the label, I have a breather. This one from here. This material will permit the air to enter and exit, but will keep the water outside. Officially, unofficially, who knows. So we are almost in. Okay, now with the T9, I have one screw here. Let me see if it's something removable. I think here it's a plug. No, let me try to see if this is removable, but it's not, or it is. This is a shield from what I see, but seems to be glued in place. Okay, so the question is how this plug it's connected inside, because if I will need to pull it like so, I have this thing from here and it's a part of this case. Let me see it. Okay, now if I have destroyed the rear case, I will start to open it from here to see if I'm able to find something here in front. Whew, this thing is killing me. I need to open it. Maybe if I will take more time, it's probably I'll be able to open it more, more clean. But now I don't have the time and I'm not interested in repairing this radar, it's sacrificed for science. Oopsie. I don't think you'll be able to open this radar without destroying it. I think it's impossible. I mean, maybe if you have a different method, but you can see how this is built. The plastic cover have an U-shaped channel filled with glue, and the aluminum case, it's insider. I don't know how you will be able to separate these two pieces. If they were both from plastic, that was easier, like the headlights. You can see it's a channel filled with glue, and the problem is it's a small area and it's very strong. You cannot peel a little bit, you need to peel it all, and the glue, it's very strong. I will cut the case. I will cut the cover. Now, until I will finish this thing, I want to read you something. A radar sensor is usually at the core of the adaptive cruise control, also known as ACC. Installed at the front of the vehicle, the system permanently monitors the road ahead. As long as the road ahead is clear, ACC maintains the speed limit set by the driver. If the system spots a slower vehicle within its detection range, it gently reduces speed by releasing the accelerator or using the brake system. If the vehicle ahead speed up or change lanes, the ACC automatically accelerates to the set speed. Standard ACC can be activated from around 30 km per hour or 20 miles per hour to maximum 200 or 124 miles per hour. The ACC stop and go can be set from the same speed, 30 km or 20 miles per hour, but it can maintain the set distance to the preceding vehicle even at very low speeds, and can decelerate to a complete standstill if the vehicle has automatic transmission. If the traffic hold up is only brief, the ACC stop and go can set the vehicle in motion once again. When the vehicle remains stopped longer than 10 seconds, the driver needs to reactivate the system by briefly stepping on the gas pedal. In this way, the ACC stop and go will work even in heavy traffic and traffic jams. Since ACC is a comfort and convenience system, brake intervention and vehicle acceleration only take place within defined limits. In newer generations, in addition to the radar sensors, the system will use the cameras of the car, the CAFAS cameras, that can detect a vehicle entering in your lane earlier than the radar can see it. Either the vehicle will enter planned by using the turn signal or unplanned by kamikaze way, enabling the system to respond more dynamically, more naturally. So that means that data from radar sensor and cameras can merge together. This thing is amazing science, and next time when you will use this system, you will better understand and you will appreciate the work behind the science. Finally, this thing is opened. Now here inside, you can see how its build. From what I see, the plug is soldered on this side. First, let's remove these screws. The same they are with T9. Something like that. I think you cannot separate these two parts. I think they are glued together here. So this inside here, this is the radar. I think it's something inside here. I'll try to pull out this cover. This here is the dome. These two things from here are connections for the heating element, because this dome is heated. Have a resistance inside here. In the winter, this will be hot and will melt the snow, in case snow will be on this radar. So these two are the connections from here. Okay, now let me see how I will pull. Oh, okay, I have remove this shield. You can see this shield was glued. Underneath here I have two more screws. Okay, now I'm able to take out this board. No. No. This board is stuck here. Oh, it's not stuck. If you are watching closely down there, you will see a little lip of glue. This board is glued here. Yeah, I can see the glue down there. Okay, yeah, the board is soldered here. But I have the tool for that. Is this beauty from here? The soldering station. Okay, let me see if I'm able to make something. This to keep it in place, because I need my hands to be free. I need to apply solder. Something like that. And it seems to work. Good. Okay, this was part of the radar. Here, okay. Now on this side, I'll do the same to that pins and to these ones. But first, let me see. Yeah, I need to do the same step. finally, the radar is dismantled. Unfortunately, this thing is not repairable at all. As you can see, this is the heated dome. This is the back case. This is a shield. The middle case with a plug. This part from here is the main board with the processor. This is a controller, I think, for the radar sensor. This board from here, it's for the radar. You can see these things are part of the radar system with this component. This was mounted here, and that one was mounted like so. I think one of these two things is the cannon that will send the waves, and the other one is the receiver. So this part from here is the radar itself, and this one is the brain. So now I know how this radar was built, was assembled in the factory. First thing was this part, the radar board, was assembled, soldered. Next step, the rear case was mounted. After that, the main processor board, because this one will need to be soldered here on the plug. And last one is the dome. And this is the radar. I also have here next generation radar. This one, I think it's a little bit easier to be repaired because it's bigger. And this one, I have dismantled it a little bit easier. This one, it's very different because that one from there, it's called long range radar. And this one, it have inside here the long range radar and close range radars. This have a motor here that will adjust this part. This thing from here will spin. And here inside, it's a part of the radar itself. This one is more smarter, better, newer, and everything else over that one. And with this, I have dismantled the idea that this radar is repairable. But maybe you are able to open this radar without destroying the case like me. But even so, I don't know what you'll be able to find and repair inside here. Maybe you can try to do reballing on the processor. Who knows, maybe there is the problem. But now, after doing this thing, I have learned a new thing. I know how this thing is built and what is inside. With this, I hope you also learned something new in this video. If you do so, you know the drill. Hit the like button. Thank you for watching these videos. Again, thank you for being with me, and till next time, stay awesome. Bye now.